This is impossible. I'm too exhausted to do anything but leave. The usual cliches are not applicable. I am not sorry. I hope I have hurt you. I do not wish to remain friends. I will labor not to remember anything about our time together. I do not wish you well. I will sell or destroy all your gifts and letters. If I could bathe my skin, my brain, and my vagina in bleach until every atom of your contamination of me was eradicated, I would. I don't know how I've lasted so long. The least effort makes me feel ill. Holding this pen and writing this letter is like pulling off wet boots. All I want to do is sleep. I'm somewhere else now. I'm in a hotel room with my distance and my clarity. You are erasing me as you read this, and I am dreaming your death. I have all the time in the world. You should remain indoors. Stay away from electrical outlets. I want to indict you, but it seems beside the point. I thought of doing hideous things to you, putting ground glass in your food, setting you on fire in your sleep. When I was leaving, I held a gun to your head until my arm got tired. You looked entirely peaceful. The gun was so pretty in the blue light. I thought how everything you've said and done and will say and will do was sitting right in there like a box full of junk. Every way you've seen me, everything we did. And I could clear it all away as easy as hosing dirt out of a screen. But I didn't want to hear the noise. It seemed vulgar. My arm got tired and I left. I can still feel the weight in my hand. I used to think your perspective was charming, even exhilarating. Your relishing of bad films, shitty weather, breaking down cars. I used to write down things you told me. Listen to this. Each experience brings sensation. Each sensation texture. Each texture a new learning. Not good or bad any longer, only more. What horse shit. I've got notebooks full. I used to hang on your every word. I used to hold the phone to my face like it was an oxygen mask. I used to want to fuck you because of sentences. What have I let you do to me? I'm removed from my species. I'm dissolving in this bed. I'm turning into powder. My face has come off in my hands. I've helped you murder me. I've helped you bury me and washed your hands. How do I rethink things at this point? What list of steps will lead me to a mirror I can look into without wanting to vomit? What do I do now? I will turn myself into a punchline. I remember a few weeks ago you were reading a book, someone's memoir, and you came across the line, "Style is morality," and you were delighted. It was like you had received some sort of benediction. You were skipping around the house, repeating it over and over. I knew what you thought, that you had company, that your jokes about cripples, about me, about everything were incisive and brave. Sleeping next to you that night was like lying in bed with a wet dog. You gathered me in and I wanted to scream. I couldn't sleep. You snored in my ear, farted all night. I just lay still, trying to hover in my skin and not touch you. I counted and said the alphabet backwards and read the names on the spines of all your books. In the morning, I got up and went to work without even showering. My back ached. People wouldn't stop talking to me. I went to a bar on my lunch break and didn't go back, and I saw how you could sit aside your whole life just like that, like a bottle of shampoo you left at a hotel. You had observed me here that you could always buy another bottle of shampoo, the exact same one, as many as you like. I used to sort of crave those little correctives until I noticed that was all you ever said. You can start another life, too. That diminishes with each copy. More grain, more smearing, a bit flatter and uglier each time. I am writing this in one of your notebooks. There are pictures down the margins of pages with just a sentence or two written. At the top of this page, it reads, "Certainly this film." That's it. On the next, it says, "The containment of that gesture." And then, "Other people's happiness disgusts me." This is your autopsy. These are your samples. I can reconstruct your corpse out of all the things you never finished saying. It will not be so difficult for you.
You will crook your finger.
You will crook your finger and someone just like me.
Some ginch or buckethead.
Will drop her drawers and shuck off her skin.
Like buying a shirt.
Like stealing a shirt.
And she will lose her species.
And her face.
And dissolve.
Possible. I am too exhausted to do anything but leave. The usual cliches are not applicable. I am not sorry. I hope I have hurt you. I do not wish to remain friends. I will labor not to remember anything about our time together. I do not wish you well. I love you. You are my sole devotion. You are the texture and circumference of my every thought, my every cell. I could not live without you.
Oh, I will sell or destroy all your gifts and letters. If I could bathe my skin, my brain, and my vagina in bleach until every atom of your contamination of me was eradicated, I would. I don't know how I've lasted so long. The least effort makes me feel ill.
I have always, since my earliest consciousness, wanted to fuck Emily Dickinson. I have always, since my earliest consciousness, wanted to fuck Emily Dickinson.
Holding this pen and writing this letter is like pulling off wet boots. All I want to do is sleep.
Departed to the judgment, a mighty afternoon, great clouds like ushers leaning, creation looking on. The flesh surrendered, canceled, the bodiless begun two worlds, like audiences disperse and leave the soul alone.